The burden of cancer in Kentucky is huge. We're number one state in cancer mortality. Kentucky has the second highest incidence of all cancers in the United States. Where that burden is particularly bad is in eastern Kentucky, is Appalachian Kentucky.
Despite the overwhelming need for advanced cancer care, Kentucky was one of only 16 states without a National Cancer Institute designated center. Until now. In July 2013, the Markey Cancer Center at the University of Kentucky joined an elite group of 67 cancer centers across the country with NCI designation.
We committed 10 years ago to strive to become a top research-intensive referral center. We got renewal of the Alzheimer's grant, and we were fortunate enough about a year and a half ago of getting CTSA designation. So with this designation, the NCI Cancer Center, we now have our trifecta. I think that with these three, we are an elite company.
It puts us in the top 3 to 4% of all cancer centers in the country. It means that patients don't have to go outside the state to get their cancer care.
We assure folks that no matter how ill they are, no matter how complex their medical problems, we in Kentucky will be able to care for them and not have to worry about whether their insurance will take them to the Mayo Clinic or the Cleveland Clinic or places like that.
As an NCI designated center, the Markey Cancer Center will see up to $1.5 million annually in additional funding. And Kentucky patients will be able to participate in clinical trials for the most promising new cancer treatments.
And in all of the complex areas of cancer, we focus on building comprehensive teams, standardizing our care. So it's never about a single doctor, it's about a system of care. And the first day we see you, that carries you through your entire treatment program.
We have a group of physicians, clinicians, as well as researchers who get together on a weekly basis to discuss the best care for our patients.
NCI designation will bolster innovative research already underway, like Suzanne Arnold's project exploring the link between environmental exposure to heavy metals and the high rate of lung cancer in eastern Kentucky. Recently recruited nanotechnology expert Peishwan Guo and Mark Evers are working on nanodrugs to selectively kill colorectal cancer cells that have spread to the liver. Peter Zhao, who is focusing on triple-negative breast cancer, has discovered how these cancer cells change their metabolism as they spread through the body. Derek St. Clair is studying ways to suppress tumors and protect the heart and brain from the toxic side effects of chemotherapy. And Vivek Rangnekar is continuing research on PAR4. A tumor suppressor gene that spares normal cells and kills cancer cells.
I think our commitment to research is fundamentally important to the economic impact in the region, because our research leads to new products, often leads to new companies, leads to a lot of dollars coming from Washington.
And with the NCI designation, that's going to shine a new light on this area in Kentucky. It's a huge boon for the economy as well. New patients coming in, new physicians will be recruited. So overall, it's going to make a dramatic impact in our region.